Public hearing on bill referred to this committee by the House. We have for consideration, number one, a bill for an act to provide for the establishment of the roads and highway forest guard charged with responsibilities. A bill for an act to forest and responsibility of kidnapping and preventing crime, banditry and terrorism appeared appended, preserve law and order and protect life and properties strictly within all our forests, lying 100 meters adjacent to federal highways. A bill for an act to amend the Nigerian Institute of Animal Science Act, CAF, of the Federation 2004 and for related matters, HB 915, number 3, a bill for an act to establish communal farms in all the 774 local government areas of the Federation to develop a sustainable agro-allied business in Nigeria for related matters, HB 1110. A bill for an act to amend the Corrupt Varieties and Livestock Breed Law of the Federation of Nigeria 2004 and for related matter, HB 36. A bill for an act to provide a legal framework and for establishment of national route and tobacco production, processing and research in zinc, Taraba State. And a bill for an act to provide for establishment of Nigerian Pesticide Council and for related matter, HB 1396. Honorable colleagues and invited guests, as you can see, we have a lot on our table to deal with today. Because of the circumstances we have found ourselves in as a nation economically, that notwithstanding as a responsive and responsible parliament, a representative of the people, we resolve as a committee with the support of the leadership of our speaker, Right Honorable Femi Bajamila, to deal with all these bills before the end of this year, 2021. So that Nigerian people will not lose the benefit of this bill to our national economy.
Here today to consider five important bills currently making their way through the legislative process in the National Assembly. These bills are, one, a bill for an act to amend the Nigerian Institute of Animal Sciences Act, CAP 150, Laws of the Federation of Nigeria 2004 and for related matters, HB 915. Two, a bill for an act to establish communal farms in all the 774 local government areas of the Federation to develop a suitable agro-allied business in Nigeria and for related matters, HB 110. Three, a bill for an act to provide for establishment of Nigeria Pesticide Council and for related matters, HB 1396. Four, a bill for an act to provide a legal framework for establishment of Nigeria National Roots and Tubers Production, Processing and Research Institute, ZING, in Taraba State, and for related matters, HB 1513. And finally, a bill for an act to amend two national crop varieties and livestock breeds registration act, CAP 27, Laws of the Federation of Nigeria 2004 and for related matters, HB 36. These bills individually and collectively seek to change our national approach to agricultural production in impactful ways, with the potential of growing our economy to provide jobs and create economic opportunities for our citizens. However, Our ability to do this depends on how well we can collaborate to ensure that the bills that emerge from this process are well thought of, effectively written, and capable of meeting the intended objectives. It also depends on our ability to ensure that the mandate of these bills are implemented effectively by those to whom we will assign different constitutional responsibilities in the final legislation. Our gathering here today, therefore, as legislators and stakeholders, provides an opportunity for us to listen to each other and be informed by the views, experiences, and concerns of one another. It is also an opportunity to agree on the best ways to achieve the laudable objectives that motivate our current legislative efforts. Therefore, it is of particular importance that we share carefully considered opinions, knowing that the work we do here today can change the future of agricultural production in our country for a long time to come.
You mentioned earlier, Taraba State, we have been predominantly farmers, and we produce the best yam in Nigeria. I mean best. If you can go to the market today, if you ask Jalingo yam, the price is different because of the quality. So by the time we improve it, we will be harvesting 2 or 3 times a year of that yam. So you see, we have boosted the production, and we will also feed not only Taraba, Northeast, we can also feed Nigeria. So that's why I came up with this bill. I think, what can I do to help our people? I realize that if we can improve this farming system, yam, cassava, and other tubes, it will go a long way in creating employment, directly and indirectly. And as I mentioned earlier, it will improve our RGR in the state and in the federal government as well. If you can remember, you know, President or federal government have introduced policy of exporting yam. Mm-hmm. But they found out the content, the water content of the yam is too high. It's spoiled on the sea. So that's why we said, okay, let's have an institution that can come up with the ideas on how to improve it so that we can be exporting it to make money. A very important occasion in the life of Taraba State. By God's grace, if our presidents are sending this bill into law, when the institution established, first of all, will benefit from employment, and then our farmers. We all know Taraba State, we are predominantly farmers, and what we farm is more especially tuba. So that's why we decided to have this institution in Taraba State. If we improve the seed of yam alone, I think will increase, even if we cannot rely 100% on the income to run our state, we can generate 50 to 60% from that idea to run our state. So I want to say a big thank you to all of you and to the committee who conducted this public hearing, and also to all the stakeholders who contributed in memorandums, their own personal inputs, their time. I want to say thank you, God bless all of you, and I wish you safe journey.